So let's do a recap. Help me just recall. ORM, okay. ORM was actually covered in the Saturday batch, Arushi. But great that you do recall that. So on the Sunday batch, I know it's, you know, you guys, I send across invitation for both the batches. Yes, we did the Google AdWords account. Absolutely right, Vinay. And what exactly we did in Google AdWords account? Rajiv, you were also part of that. So any, do you remember and recall that? Arushi, I believe even you were part of the Google AdWords account one, right? So do you remember and recall what we did? We did the keyword planner. Absolutely. We did MCC account. We also understood Rohit, the account structure. Absolutely. All right. So let's get started. The search partners and all. All right. So we were actually getting, I made you understand the overall, the settings of the search, the Google search campaign, right? So I'll open the same stuff again. I'll rather open the PPT first of all, and then just do a recap, because doing a recap is very much essential in order to go ahead and let you know everything. All right, just give me a moment. All right, so we started with understanding what Google AdWords is, right? So what are paid ads and what are non-paid ads? We understood that in the basics class, right? Then we went ahead. I also showed you, this is the certificate, guys, which you get after you clear the Google AdWords exam. All right, so after we would be done by Google AdWords, I will definitely make sure that each one of you get the Google AdWords certification. All right, so all of you would be getting that for sure. All right, so we started with understanding these basic stuff, guys, that the paid ads are the ones which are there on the top and on also on the right hand sides. These are the search ads, and the ones over here are the organic ones. We covered that part. These are also called pay-per-click ads, which are PPC, right? PPC stands for pay-per-click, and SEO stands for search engine optimization, right? In the very first session, we also understood what is the difference between AdWords and AdSense. If you guys remember, that was just like, I mean, the 3 weeks back, we understood the difference between AdWords and AdSense, right? In case you have forgotten something, I would request you to please go ahead and look into the videos, guys, the recordings of the past sessions, right? I would share across with you the URL of the YouTube channel on the in the chat window. So I'm just typing that across. All right, so do refer to this particular URL, guys, which I have written across in the chat window. All right, so once you click that, you would get to see all the videos which are over here of the sessions which we have done previously, right? You can go onto the playlist section, and under the playlist section, you can see Sunday batch September 13 onwards. So this is the batch, guys, for this is the Sunday batch which is going on right now. All right, so I repeat again, I have shared with you the URL of the recordings of the sessions which have happened before, and once you click onto that, you can go to the playlist section, and within playlist section you have Sunday batch September 13th one, right? So you can go ahead and get yourself you know, accustomed to what exactly we have covered so far. All right, going back to the same stuff. So we understood the AdWords and AdSense difference. We also understood that there are two various different formats: text ads, image ads, and video ads. There are three formats, guys, which are major formats within Google AdWords. So we cannot just go ahead and create text ads on the search engine, but also we can create the display ads. We will be taking that today, and also the video ads, right? We understood that. So it's just including the last to last week's session in all, there are three videos so far, or has the last Sunday session not been added so far? Last Sunday we didn't have any session. So all the sessions are there uploaded across. So none of the sessions recording is missing, Rohit. Every session recording is there in those three videos for this particular batch. All right. Okay, so we started with understanding AdWords. You need to have an AdWords account, which is adwords.google.com, right? Adwords.google.com, where you can go ahead and sign in across with the username and password, right? Once you do that, it'll ask you some basic little details like what time zone are you in, which country are you in, whether it's India, US, Canada, or so forth. And then you go ahead and save that across. Once you do that, you will be able to sign in into your account and you will be able to create your first campaign. We have covered Google AdWords structure. Can anybody help me recall what is the overall AdWords structure like, guys? Right, so Sundar, you are logging in your webcam, so I would request you not to do that. All right, thanks. So AdWords account does have its own structure. Does anybody remember and recall that? What is this overall hierarchy of the AdWords account? So Vinay, Rohit, Rajiv, Arushi, Nandkumar. All right, so Rohit says AdWords account is the biggest one, and then we have a campaign, and then we have ad groups, and then we have the keywords. And after, in between ad groups and keywords, you have the ad copy also. Absolutely right, Rohit. That's the one, right? I hope everybody agrees to what Rohit did mention. That is the overall account structure, guys. I'll move further, and then I hope everybody will remember and recall that. So it's very important to refer to the recordings, guys. Whatever session we do refer to that recording once again so that it becomes soaked into your head very easily, right? All right, I would just check whether I'm recording the session today or not. Absolutely, it is getting recorded. All right. So once you get on to this particular screen, where it asks you to create your first campaign, you click onto the button which is create your first campaign, and then it will ask you what is the campaign name, the type, right? Whether you want all the features or standard. I'll just show you that live. And then it asks you to go ahead and create your campaign by creating headline and description line one, description line two. I believe we didn't do that, or did we? I don't remember and recall that. We also did we selected the keywords and created the account ad? Vinay says no. All right, okay, I'll take that then, because I'm not able to recall that. All right, so maybe then we just did the settings part. I'll come on to that. So okay, what we have done so far is this AdWords structure we have covered, right? If you remember, account is the most we tried, but didn't work. Okay, Rajiv, thanks for reminding me. All right, so account is the first thing, guys, which is the most important one, and which comes in first. Your Google AdWords account is on the top, which gets opened up across with a unique email address and a password, and then you have a billing information, your debit card or credit card linked to your account. Underneath account, you have various campaigns. If you remember, this was the overall structure, guys, which I've made you understand in much more detail how this entire thing works. So for every campaign, you have a daily budget, location targeting. We did cover the location targeting, whether I want to show my ads in a specific country, on a specific pin code, in a specific city. If I want to exclude certain city or certain area, I can go ahead and exclude that also. I can do the language targeting, whether it's English or Hindi or whatever languages are mentioned within Google AdWords account. Plus the distribution preference, guys, accelerated and standard. There were two distribution preferences. If I want to run my ads in a faster way, then I would select accelerated. If I want my advertisement to be shown across throughout the day, if I have lower budget, if I have low budget and this clicks are there quite a lot, then I can go ahead and select on standard and make my ad run across for the entire day. I hope everybody remembers and recalls all these things. I can also do the scheduling part. When do I want to start my ad and when do I want to end the ad? Automatically, it will end on that particular date, right? So for every campaign, we have these settings, and underneath campaign, we have the ad groups, right? And underneath ad groups, we have set of ad copies and the set of keywords which are linked to every ad copy and ad group. This was another example where we have seen that relevancy part becomes way too important. If we have an auto repair shop, the kind of campaign, one of the campaign is auto repair, and underneath auto repair campaign, we have three major ad groups, one of being oil change, brake repair, and AC repair. The keywords and the ad copies within the ad group are very much in sync with the overall theme of the ad group. So it was oil change related keyword and oil change related ad copy underneath this ad group. Similarly for brake repair and AC repair, so forth and so on. So just skipping across and moving further, we also took this example of which particular ad looks much more appropriate. If somebody types in 8 megapixel camera, which of the ad is much more relevant? We understood that this one is much more better because it's talking in the same line what the end audience is actually looking at, right? So this is not the, this is not on the same lines, right? So we understood that. We also understood the overall character limit, which is allowed by Google, character limits, which is allowed by Google in the overall ad copy. So 25 being headline, which is this, then 35, 35, 35, right? Which is description line one being 35 characters, description line two being 35, display URL being 35 again, and then destination URL is the exact landing page. Does everybody remember the difference between display URL and destination URL, guys? Difference between, Rohit says yes. All right. So Rohit remembers that. How about others? Vinay, do you remember that? Rajiv, do you remember? All right. Thanks, Vinay. Thank you, Rajiv. Thank you, Arushi, for replying in. Thanks a lot, Nand Kumar. Great. And do you remember what is the character limit for the destination URL? All right. So I have an answer from Rajiv. How about others? The character limits for the destination URL, guys. Arushi says 1024, Nand Kumar says 1024, Rajiv, Nand Kumar, everybody, absolutely great. So that's right, guys. So it was 1024 for the destination URL. Okay, I'm just playing across. I'm so sorry for that. I'll just get that removed. This was not working fine. All right. So that's with the respect to the ad copy creation. Then comes in, just a second. Okay. Then comes in the, some more examples we have taken, which ad copy is best, which ad copy is not. I'm skipping across that. We did cover that. All right. So let's go on to the practical part again. And today we're going to cover keyword match types also. And we'll get that account set up, which we had created last time. So I'll open the AdWords account, my MCC account I'm going to open. And once I open my MCC account, guys, I do want you to send me across your customer IDs of your specific AdWords account. So it's very important that you go ahead and do that practically. Has anyone has anyone gone ahead and tried working on the AdWords account and made some advertisements, guys? So you can take, all right, so, okay, great. Good, Vinay, good, Rajiv, good, Nand Kumar, great, Rajiv, Nand Kumar, Vinay. That's great. So no website. Absolutely. I would get you the website for sure. I am just so give me time till 20th. I am not working actually, guys, till 20th. I have something to actually take care of right now. After that, I'll get you website for sure. No website. All right. I'll definitely get you website after 20th. I would. All right. Thanks. Okay. So we have more people joining in. Great. So we have Aman and Anil. So, okay. Swandeep, are you able to grasps what I have been speaking so far? Swandeep, Sundar, Sagar, maybe this is your first session. I'm not really sure. Aman and Anil, welcome to the session. All right. So I go to the account which I had taken previously. All right. Rather, I'll just open another one. Okay, the one which we had created was this one, maybe. Let me just see. So we had created this one, I believe. Hey, hi, Anil. Okay, so that was my MCC account, guys. What you guys can do is you can WhatsApp me across. So WhatsApp is the right way to get in touch with me. You can WhatsApp me across your manager ID, which is over here, the 10-digit, excuse me, the 10-digit manager ID, so that I can send you across a request from my MCC account. All right. Or you have sent it on can you send it on WhatsApp? That'll be great. If you have done that, maybe you can send that again. I didn't receive that. Okay. If you've done that, just send me across once again. I'll send you across the request. All right. So the campaign which we created last time was this specific one. the settings which we have seen. So this is the AdWords account, guys. You have to get very much familiarized with the AdWords account. All right. So what's going to happen? Devices and all right. So Anil, I'm going to put you on mute. You were on unmute. All right. So does everybody remember the delivery method part, which is the standard and the accelerated? Any doubt on that? Do let me know, guys, in case you have. All right. Thanks, Vinay. Okay. Underneath advanced settings, we also covered what is the, okay. We did talk about the ad scheduling part, right? So I'll take right from the beginning. We created one of the campaign and that we let the name of the campaign be campaign one. So we named it as campaign one. We had selected as the type as search network only. So there were various other options, which were display, video, search plus display and search, right? So out of all of that, we have selected only search. And within networks, I did tell you there are various sites which comes under Google network, search networks like Google Maps, AOL search engine, and various other small search engines, Google Maps, Gmail, so forth and so on, right? And then comes in device. We can make changes to bids on devices. I'll come on to the bid part at a later stage. Location also, I made you understood, right? Then also we understood the language part. If you remember, we can go ahead and change the language also. Plus, initially we had selected bid strategy as focus on clicks. Okay. So as there were various other ways through which we can go ahead and change the bids, I would take that at a later stage. So initially what we have done, either we click on AdWords will set my bid, or I can go ahead and change. I will manually set my bid. Okay, I would manually set my bid and I go ahead and click on save. And the budget I had mentioned was 100 rupees a day. Now, ad extensions. Did we speak about ad extension, the site link ad extensions and also location and call extension? I believe we did, right? So ad extensions were covered in terms of the site link, call and also the location extension. Do help me in remembering, guys. Site link, the call extension and also the location extensions were covered, right? The ad extensions, which were, all right, so I'm yet to hear from you guys. Does anybody remember and recall the ad extensions? So call extensions, I had made you understood how the call extensions look like. Is the chat, all right, so yes says Vinay, yes says Arushi, all right. Okay, great. Thanks, Nandkumar. All right. So these were the account. We had created these ad extensions, right? I'll show you that once again. Today, what I have to do is, first of all, make you understand how do the advertisement work. So once all these major things have been set up by us, right? There is an option of ad delivery, which is ad rotation also. We can go ahead and click on optimize for clicks. So this is going to be a bit tricky later on. I would make you understand what conversions stand for. Till the time your ad doesn't really run across for 10-15 days, this option is not going to be available for you. We can let AdWords know that our ad should rotate in a fashion that it should get optimized for either clicks or for conversions. Now, conversion setting is another thing which I'll show you once we start getting to create an advertisement. All right, so rather, let me show you by creating a new ad separately, guys. I think that will be the best way. It will take another 10-15 minutes, but it will give you a good recap. So I will start right from the beginning. When I say in the beginning, I mean, I'll just rush through what we had done earlier. All right, so I'm just logging into one of my AdWords account, which I use it for digital marketing part channel only. So I've got the campaigns closed right now. So what the very first thing which I do, let's say if I want to create a campaign for digital marketing part channel for the for Gurgaon location, what I'm going to do, I'm going to click on plus new campaign. And okay, now this is something which has come up again. This is something which has come in new, which is universal app campaign. All right, so what I'm going to do right now is search campaign. When I click on search campaign, Okay, I am going to select all features, which I did last time also. All features, search network only, and then Gurgaon DMP campaign. And then I go ahead and I don't want to load setting any setting from existing campaign. So I did tell you last time that if I already have a campaign running, I can load, I can sort of copy paste the settings from any existing campaign. I don't want to do that right now. I want to show you everything. We've selected the networks part. All the devices are set up by default. I can choose the overall location. So let's say if I do go ahead and select only Gurgaon right now, I can do the internal settings also. And then I go with the just a sec. Languages as English. Then I will manually set my bids. I set my bid, let's say default bid as 50 rupees, 50 rupees right now, and then my daily budget being, let's say, 500 rupees. All right, and I can use this specific button. All right, Anil, what exactly is that? I'm not really sure. Okay, this is used, guys, if you want to share across your 500 rupees budget across with other campaigns also. All right, so I have another campaign which is running across, and that is for 478 rupees. I can share that, or I want to have an individual budget for my campaign. I can set that up. I hope you're clear on that. If I want to share across a budget of a different campaign, then I can use this part. Otherwise, I can give a separate budget to a separate campaign. Every campaign having its own budget. All right. Now these were the ad extensions, guys. So if I use, let's say, this particular ad, ex one of the call extension. One of the call extension which I use, let's say, is already created. I can create site links also. I can create location extension also. All right, so all right, so I think I've already shown you. Should I spend in time over there? I just have to add in the address. I can, so site links, location, I have already shown you. I'm gonna skip that part. There are various other extensions, guys, which are not that relevant as of now to begin with. First of all, the major ones are location, sitelink, and call extension. You can have app extension if you have an app. So if you have a mobile app, then you can share across the overall URL of your mobile app, which is either in the Google Play Store URL or the iTunes URL or whichever one, right? Plus, if you have, let's say, certain reviews across, you can submit across those review. All right. So I had okay, this was being disapproved because a certain reason I had not selected the right right what do you say source for that. So you need to have a source. I can go ahead and select the source URL has to be correct. So I can go ahead and create that. Should I take that? So let me do that right now and show you. So let's say if there are certain reviews which are there. All right, so here you go. There are certain reviews over here. I can go ahead and take this one of this URL. So one of this review, I can go ahead and submit that across. Let's see whether this is going to get submitted across or not. The text actually is all right. So it's saying it's quite lengthy. So Arushi says sources implies where the reviews were originally written. Absolutely right. So originally written, they have been originally written across on my Google Plus page of Digital Marketing Pathshala. So I'm going to give that across. I'd rather take another one which is not that lengthy, and I'll post that across. Right, so I'll copy this and maybe get this one across over here. So even this is not really up to the mark in terms of the length, so it's not. Okay, still it's a problem. Okay, and here's the source. I take the source URL and I go ahead and submit across the source URL over here. All right, so can't the review source be same, be some non-Google entity? It can be. Say, for example, I'm a restaurant, so I can change the, absolutely you can. You can do that. So HTTPS, so I am taking because I have it on Google only, I can take the other one also. But it's actually going to be totally on the discretion of Google to whether to approve it or to not approve it. If it's from a very recognized website, let's say Zomato is very renowned one, so it will be actually, okay. So it would be actually approved for sure. So source is required and I would have to go ahead and delete some more words over here. Strange. This is, I never knew that this is going to happen. I have hardly used. Okay, some settings have got changed, guys. Not really sure why is this not showing like this. Let me say the source name must match the URL domain name. The URL domain name. Okay, I'll check that later on why this is not taking. It should actually, but source is required. Saying again, I'm mentioning the source, but still. So paraphrased. No, value provided is too long. Okay, over here, value provided is too long for them. Why is that? They should not do it this way. Let me just go ahead and give them the overall URL of the Google Plus page. Sorry guys for the trouble, just give me a second. I'll try if this can get solved easily. All right, it has been, it's been done. So, okay, it was the URL limitation. Earlier there was no URL limitation. Google reviews used to be there. So this has been submitted across. So you can have an app extension, review extension. I'm not getting anything. Okay, Anil, maybe this is your first session. Anil, are you part of any other? I'm not sure. So this is for the first time you're coming in. That's why probably you're not getting in. Now, there is another thing, guys, which is called callout extension. Have you read about Google Google AdWords, Anil? So callout extensions are, guys, non-clickable text. So we have, just like we have citing extensions, we have, okay, I've already told you about this, about callout extension, I believe. So if you create certain text which is not clickable, that is callout extension. And these extensions comes in as an add-on to the entire ad, but they are not clickable text. Okay, so I can go ahead and create one more, which is, let's say, so if I type in, let's say, more than 10 certifications is what we actually deliver across to each one of our students. So it says, All right, so more than 10 plus certifications I have entered across. So what I'm doing right now, structured seven snippets is something which has come in right now. This is very much like Google Callout extension only. I'm yet to actually look into that. I'll let you know. The other snippets, the other extensions, which are famous ones, are Callout, Reviews, App, the call extension so that the call phone number actually comes over, and the site link, which are extended links to your internal pages. Then you have the location extension to showcase across the Google Map listing. All right, coming further down, I can schedule my ad from 11th October, let's say, if I want to do it till 31st, right? Then the ad delivery, ad rotation, I've already told you. So I can go for optimize for clicks as of now. I'm not going for conversions. Conversions, this is applicable right now because I've got different campaigns running across. I'll show you the conversion part later on. You go ahead and do that. Now, once you save across, then now comes across an ad group. After creation of the campaign, this thing which comes across is creation of the ad group. Ad group one, which is Gurgaon. Let's say Gurgaon ad group one. Maybe I can mention that across. And then I can go ahead and click on text ad. And this text ad, guys, is going to be, let's say, this is 25. You can see then 35, then 35, and then display URL being there, which is 35, and this is 1024. They don't really go ahead and tell you over here 1024, but actual thing is 1024. So headline, if I say, so whatever you think is gonna exp so Nick, dynamic search URLs would be covered data. Yes, it would be, or maybe you had covered it earlier, in which case I'll go through the earlier videos. Okay, it would be covered later. Dynamic search ads. So dynamic search ads are gonna be for not dynamic search URLs, dynamic search ads are there. So search URLs are actually created when you have web development. Within the web development, you create dynamic URLs, which gets created on its own. So dynamic would be covered absolutely later on. Best certified. Okay, I'm typing across the description line one. Best certified. Industry trainer. So something which I feel is going to excite my end audience in terms of after reading this. Okay, so if I type in across free website, and then whatever you think is gonna really make a lot of sense. So only 75 INR. Call now. Okay, maybe call. That's it. So something, some call to action needs to be there in order to make your end audience go ahead and make an action. So I would take a display URL, guys, of my landing page. One of my landing page URL is, which I already have in place. All right, this is the one. So I'm as of now placing this one across. I'm showing you the landing page, guys, the landing page which I have across for my campaign, which is this. All right, so where the overall conversion is going to happen at this landing page, when someone will come onto this landing page, submit across his name, email address, and phone number, and then click on the button, right? A lead will actually be captured across. All right, so this is the entire landing page, guys, which I have in place. All right, so I go ahead and enter across the final URL first. So I enter the destination URL first, guys. All right, so here you go, and then the display URL comes in. The display URL, it's pretty long, more than the 35 characters. So I go ahead. Okay, So that's the display URL, guys. Now comes in. So are there any URLs different for my mobile version? Not really. I don't have a different website for my mobile as a mobile website. I have the same website which opens up perfectly. All right, so add URL options. This is again tracking template, which is a bit on the technical end. That is something which can be taken at a later stage. The major important part is now to actually go ahead and select the keywords. What we have done, we have, after adding on the settings part, we have went ahead and created a name, given a name to the ad group. After giving a name to the ad group, we have given across the overall ad text copy. The ad text copy has been set up. Similarly, you would do that for your particular website, which is for whichever you are going to do. Then you go ahead and enter across keywords. For which keyword do you want to run across? So you have to make your best judgment and then go ahead and enter across. So now today, in another 5-10 minutes, I'm going to talk about how this thing, keyword thing, actually works. You know, when I say keyword thing, keyword match types are something which is very much important to understand when we run across Google Ads. All right, so the other, let's say I will select some more keywords, which is, let's say, social marketing course, online marketing courses, online marketing training course, and online marketing course, web marketing courses, and then online courses, marketing, not really. I go ahead and select some more and then let you know about on the keyword match type. Then comes in search engine marketing course, SEO marketing course, so forth and so on. All right. So I have selected some of these keywords, guys. I would rather take the search engine related keywords in a different ad group. So I will have a different ad group for search engine marketing related keywords. I'll have a different ad group for SEO related keywords. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this. All right. It's all about the relevancy, right? So I will have relevancy across on one of my ad group. Now I have decided the maximum CPC to be 50 rupees. I go ahead and click on save ad group. Once I do that, my ad is live across, guys. My ad is live and these are the keywords which we have selected. It shows me across. You can see over here the keywords being there. And keywords which are represented over here are online marketing courses, online marketing course, online marketing courses. It says it's eligible, it's approved, right? It gives me a quality score also, that 6 out of 10. As the ad will run, I'll have much more quality score being there. Okay, now the other stuff which I want to tell you guys with respect to these keywords, there are three things which are related within the keywords only, which there are three match types. What are match types? Let me show you. If you take the overall cursor to somewhere near to this particular keyword and you click over here, let's say you click over here, it says before you edit this keyword, if you say that I want to edit this keyword, it will give you this particular pop-up which says changing the keyword text or match type, right? So I'll just tell you where exactly your ad is going to be displayed also, right? First you need to go ahead and click on ISI understand. These are three match keywords. Absolutely, Rajiv, I'll take that. I'll take your question for sure. Where exactly our ad is going to be shown. As of now, the ad is going to be shown across for those keywords which we have selected. But before understanding that, it's very important to know these three match keywords. If you see this, for every keyword, there are three match types, guys. Broad, exact, and phrase. What exactly are these? I'll just tell you right now. Just have a look, broad, exact, and phrase match. What this happens, let's say if I do it broad match, guys, I select it as broad match. The URL, the overall keyword remains like this only. If I select the phrase match, which is this one, what will happen? The inverted commas comes in. The inverted commas comes across for phrase match. And if I select exact match, the brackets, these brackets actually come across, okay? Now, what exactly are these? Why Google has given us this option? Let me show you. If I have done it exact match, guys, what will happen? If somebody who's out there in Gurgaon, since I've selected Gurgaon, types in across this keyword, online marketing course, all right? So let's say when we go to google.com and we type in across this keyword, online I'm right now not in Gurgaon, so the ad will not appear, right, guys? But if somebody is over here, here in Gurgaon, can actually check that. Online marketing course, let's say if it's being typed across, the ad will either appear on these three top positions or somewhere over here on the right-hand side. All right, somewhere over here or on the right-hand side. You have so many institutes which are spending across money and trying to actually get their trying to get as many leads who of all those people who are trying to learn online marketing course. All right, now what has happened with the keyword match types, guys? If I have selected exact match, then the brackets come in, and when somebody type in online marketing course, then my ad will appear. Okay, if the same entire keyword is typed across online marketing course, right? Let's say if online marketing is only typed across, then my ad will not appear. My ad will never appear if online marketing. Let me share with you the PPT and then show you step by step perfectly what keyword match types are. All right, so just give me a second. It's very important to run across, understand the keyword match type so that you can optimize your advertisement and show your advertisement to right people, and so that you don't spend in money by showing your ads to those people who are not looking for your product and service. And you should not be paying across for clicks which are happening by which are getting done by those or a set of people who don't really need your services. Okay, if you don't understand keyword match types, there is a possibility that you will end up spending money unnecessarily, and your money will keep spending. You will keep getting clicks, but not many conversions. What is the objective at the end of the day? At the end of the day, the objective is to get maximum number of conversions with lesser number of money which we are spending, right? If I'm not wrong. Would you like, okay, if I give you two scenarios, guys. Scenario one, 10 clicks and one conversion, okay? And another scenario, 10 clicks and three conversions, three form submissions. Which one is much more better? 10 clicks with one form submission or 10 clicks with three form submissions? When I say form submissions, these are the with the three one, absolutely, right? So whenever you run campaigns, guys, you are never ever targeting for maximum number of impressions, or you're not targeting for maximum number of clicks. That is not at all the objective. The objective is to get maximum number of conversions. And for maximum number of conversions, we have to optimize our entire Google Ads by using great content in the ad copy, by placing across, by doing a lot of hit and trial in the ad copy, so forth and so on. And also with the keyword match types. What are keyword match types? Let me move ahead with this and show you. So there are, like I told you, broad match first, then broad match modifier. You can actually ignore that part. This was something which was there earlier. Now Google has actually discontinued almost, and not many people use it also. Then you have phrase match, exact match. These were the three which I've already shown you, right? If you remember, I had shown you with phrase match, there were inverted commas, right? There was inverted commas before the keyword and after the keyword. And with the exact match, I had shown you the bracket was there before and after the keyword, right? And for broad match, there was nothing. There was no punctuation at all right? There was no punctuation before or after the keyword. Then we have a negative match also. What exactly negative match is all about? Let me show you. All right. Let me help you with the make you understand with the help of example. Now what happens, let's say this is broad match keyword, guys. If we are running across our advertisement for a keyword, tennis shoes, okay? And we have set that up, this particular keyword for on broad match. Now when all my advertisement will trigger, for what all keywords my advertisement will trigger if this particular keyword which I have chosen is on broad match, okay? What broad match says that any particular word out of these two words within my keyword is made up of two words, okay? If I have set it up on broad match, any specific word, whether it's tennis or whether it's shoes, if any of them is used in the key phrase which the end audience is typing across in Google, the advertisement will trigger. For example, if somebody types in buy tennis shoes, okay? Now, any word before this word, comes across, and tennis shoes is definitely there. Then also ad will appear. And if somebody types in best shoes for tennis, what is happening over here? A new, you know, a word before this keyword comes in, and the overall, you know, the sequence also changes. Shoes comes in first over here, and tennis comes in later. Then also ad will trigger. Then another example, tennis shoes laces. Tennis shoes, both of the words are coming, and laces something which is added on extra. Any word added after, any word added before, any word added in between, the sequence changes, or any word not even being missing across. At least one word should be present in broad match. If we are running across our ad on, let's say, these two words, any one word minimum should come across. There is no if and but in terms of the sequence. There is no if and but in terms of the words which will come after or words which will come before in the search query. For running shoes also, you can see running is there, and then only shoes is actually part of it. Then also ad will appear. And if it's tennis and then sneakers, right? Tennis and sneakers, only one word is part of it. Then ad will trigger. For all these permutation and combinations, your ad will trigger if your keyword is set up on broad match. Now, what will happen with phrase? It will get much more clear when I'll come on to the phrase and exact. Have a look. With phrase match, if the same keyword, tennis shoes, right? Same keyword has been taken now, not on broad match, but it is taken on phrase match. What happens? The inverted commas comes up automatically with phrase match. Now, my ad will only trigger when these two words will actually come in together. With broad, what was happening? Either of the words, either of the two words needs to be there at least, and anything after or before can be a part of it, right? And the sequence, if that both the words were coming in the broad match, the sequence was also not a constraint. Over here, only constraint is that both the words should come in, and that too in same sequence. So over here, what is happening? Tennis shoes, your ad will trigger for these two situations. Tennis shoes comes in together. Tennis and shoes are coming in together. Any word put after these two words or any word put in before will also trigger it. But the only main criteria with phrase match is that these two words should come in together, and anything after or before can be there. And also the sequence should not also be altered. The search query, when it's being typed across, the sequence should not at all be altered. Even with red tennis shoes, it will actually trigger the, if there is some spelling mistake, it's related, or singular plural thing is taken into account. But over here, ads won't show for these keywords. If somebody types in shoes for tennis, you know, shoes is coming first and tennis is coming third, and you have a word in between. For phrase match, this will not work. Had this been broad, not phrase match, for this keyword, if somebody would have typed in this keyword, the ad would have triggered. The ad would have come up across on the search results. If somebody would have mentioned across tennis sneakers, then also the ad will not appear if it's set up on phrase match. All right. If this would have been in broad match, tennis shoes would have been broad match, then for tennis sneakers, this would have to got triggered. The ad would have got triggered. Similarly, now for exact match, I want to show you what happens with exact match. Tennis and shoes, two words, they both have to come in together. Plus, so that was there with phrase also, that both the words have to come in together. But with phrase match, what was there, that any word after or before or after the keyword can come in and the ad can trigger. Over here, no. Only this specific word has to come in so that the ad can trigger. Over here, if somebody types in tennis shoes, or a spelling mistake can also be taken. If somebody types in only tennis shoes, then only ad will appear. Even for red tennis shoes, the ad will not appear. Had it been phrase match, then for red tennis shoes, the ad would have triggered. Any questions so far, guys? Are you guys clear on to the three match types which I have spoken so far? Vinay, Swandeep, Sundar. Sandeep, welcome to the session. Sagar, Rohit, Rajiv, Payal, Nandkumar, Arushi. All right. Yes, says Vinay. Yes, says Arushi. Yes, says Nandkumar. Great. Sagar, Sandeep, Rohit. All right. Great, guys. So now this is very important in terms of understanding. All right. Do you need more examples? It's all clear. All right. It's all clear, I believe. Any more examples in case you guys want to go ahead and check on that? Do, I would say, do a search on Google in terms of the difference between these three phrase matches. Now, why do we use them? Another set of question which we should understand, why Google has given us this functionality of using these match types. Let me make you understand that. Let's say if I'm running across my ad on Broadmatch, okay? If I'm running across my ad on Broadmatch, then, and I am selling across only tennis shoes, okay? I'm selling across only tennis shoes and I'm not selling across tennis sneakers, or if I'm not selling across tennis racket or tennis ball, then Broadmatch is something which is not advisable for me. Why is that? I have a question for each one of you. Now, this is Broadmatch. Let's say if I'm running across my advertisement for tennis shoes on Broad, will the ad trigger if somebody will type in tennis shoe laces? If somebody types in tennis shoe laces and the ad which is being set up by us at the back end is on Broad, will it trigger? Yes, is Rajiv. Yes, is Rohit. Absolutely right. It will trigger because it's Broad. Only one word. The overall criteria is that any one word should come. But tell me one thing, if I'm running it across on Broad and I'm not selling tennis shoe laces, only which I'm selling across is tennis shoes, do you think running on Broad is a good idea? If I'm not selling laces, it's not a good idea, right? Rajiv says no. It is gonna just hurt me. It will just, if I'll run my ad on Broad, and I will get a lot of clicks for various other keywords like tennis ball, tennis racket, tennis shoe laces, tennis this, tennis that. If I'm not selling across tennis racket, if I'm not selling tennis shoe laces, if I'm not selling tennis balls, there is no point in running Broad. Only there are very less organizations which run across advertisements on Broad match keywords, guys. Only those people who are not aware of Google AdWords, what Google AdWords is, they feel that they are very confident, they know how to create the ad, but they don't know about AdWords keyword match types. What happens, they are doing it for the first time and then they drain their money, they burn their money and they just put it across in the dustbin and nothing happens. Because by default, if you don't change the match types, by default, your ad will run on the Broad match and you will not even come to know that your money is going ahead and your money is getting spent for a lot of searches of keywords for which you are not at all dealing into, right? So if you are dealing only into tennis shoes, then I would say go ahead and have something like phrase match or exact match. Organizations who run on Broad match are something like Pepsi, Coke, or various other bigger brands who are just crazy about branding, guys. Many organizations which have deep pockets, which have a lot of money to burn across, they are the ones only who run their advertisements on Broad. They want for every single word their ad should appear and people should get to know about that. So advertisers with huge budget. Okay, now if I am selling across only tennis shoes, then it makes sense to have on phrase match, guys, right? So if I'm putting across tennis shoes and that too in, inverted commas comes in and that I'm running across on phrase match, then let's say somebody types across tennis racket. Will the ad trigger if somebody types in tennis racket and it's in phrase match? No, says Rajiv. No, says Sagar. How about others? Vinay, would it do? Arushi says no. All right. No, says Swandeep. No, says Vinay. Absolutely, it will not. Now, this is something good, right? If I'm not selling across tennis rackets with phrase match, it is not at all going to be coming across. My ad will not show and I will not end up paying a lot of money. I won't pay extra money. But let's say in this case, guys, if somebody types in tennis shoes for women, all right? If somebody types in tennis shoes for women, then would the ad appear? Sagar says yes. Sandeep says yes. Rajiv says. All right. I have a question now. Now, let's say if I... okay, great, guys. Nice answer. I'll take your question Rohit, in a while, in just 1 second, I'll read that out. So tennis shoes for women, if it comes across, the ad will trigger. But if I have, if I don't sell across tennis shoes for women, if I sell it across on for men, then either one way is to have a keyword like tennis shoes for men only on phrase match. One way is to have phrase match on a keyword like tennis shoes for men, so that if somebody types in tennis shoes for women, tennis shoes laces, let's say if somebody types in tennis shoes laces also, then also my ad can trigger on phrase match. So I can be in trouble if I don't sell laces. For that separate thing, for this thing, guys, there is something which is being introduced by Google that is called negative match. What happens with negative, if I type across, all right, let me show you what happens with negative. If I put across a negative keyword as women, all right, if I put across negative keyword as women, then tennis shoes for women, if is being typed across and it's on phrase match, then it will not appear, because I have told Google that if any of the keyword which will have women in it, my ad will never ever appear. So for an example, if I also put across laces, I put across ball, or I put across words like racket, you know, if I am not selling across tennis racket, I'm not selling tennis shoes for women, anything related to tennis, which is related to women, laces, ball, racket, so forth and so on, I'm not selling across, I can put them across on negative, no matter what, whether it's on broad or whether it's on phrase match, my ad will not appear if any of these words are used across in their search queries, guys. All right, so I have a question from Rohit. Let me read that out. But if you are starting promoting ads on Google, won't it be helpful to get your ads across to as many people who are closely looking for stuff related to tennis? Also, it can give you an idea of what all keywords people are using to search for stuff related to tennis. All right, so Rohit, if you are into the research mode, you have money to go ahead and spend and get to know what people are typing across, then I would say it's better to use Google Keyword Planner tool. Google Keyword Planner tool tells you how many people are typing what sort of keywords. So if you are trying to judge, maybe the point which you're trying to make, that you can get to know what people are typing across in Google, and you can start keeping those products, then the best thing is to go ahead and look for search demand, the search query on Google Keyword Planner tool. Have you seen the Google Keyword Planner tool? I think I have shown you, right? Where you can go ahead and see how many people have typed across, right? So that's the idea. You don't need to spend in a lot of money for that. Okay, Nandkumar, I'll show you. The Google Keyword Planner tool actually gives you a lot of ideas about what all keywords are there which are being searched across by people in Google on monthly basis. On monthly basis, this keyword is being searched across by 2,200 people, or being typed across by 2,800 people, so forth and so on. So Rohit says, okay, but from a digital marketing best practice followed industry, mostly organization do not use broad match. No, mostly don't use, but very less organizations do. From the branding, websites which are looking at branding, only they use that. Otherwise, you have limited budget all the time, Rohit. Client will say that I have got 1 lakh rupees. Out of 1 lakh rupees, I only want conversions. I'm not looking at doing a lot of research, you know. So for getting ROI from your limited budget, you have to take these best practices of optimizing your ads. And broad match is never ever a great technique when you're looking at getting ROI. All right, this is the Keyword Planner tool. Nandkumar, what you can do is just type across on Google Keyword Planner tool, and this tool gives you a lot of information about what all other keywords you can go ahead and type across. Have it for your specific, just a sec, tools and then keyword planner. So tools and then keyword planner. All right. So, okay, what happens with this keyword planner tool? You can type across one keyword and it can give you a lot of information. So let's say if I type in, let's say tennis shoes only, tennis shoes, and I don't have a landing page right now to give them across. Otherwise, I can go ahead and give them a landing page, mention the product category also. I'm not doing that right now. Last time we did that. And then just go ahead and click on get ideas. All right. It'll give you a lot of ideas, Nand Kumar, in terms of what all keywords people are typing across in Google. So I can go further down. It gives me keyword ideas here. Okay. So what you can see over here, this particular tool, Keyword Planner, gives me that this specific keyword, tennis shoes online, in exact match. In exact match, this search query is typed across by 590 people on a monthly basis. This keyword, best tennis shoes, is typed across by 110 people only. This, which keyword is in demand, which keyword is not in demand, all of that. So you can see 480 for keyword like tennis shoes online India, right? Keyword like buy tennis shoes is just 40, right? Only 40 people on an average. So forth and so on, right? So that's with Keyword Planner. It's just good to know from while deciding on the keywords, right? Which keyword should we go ahead with? Okay, now guys, this is about the keyword match types. I can show you how to put in the negative keywords also and how to change these phrase match and the exact match. So as of now, I can go ahead and change for all the keywords. I can make them from broad to phrase, let's say. I can also make this from broad to phrase. I can do it for all of them. So I can select all of them and go ahead and click on edit part and then click on change match types. I select all of them. This is the rule to actually get done for all of them, and then click on edit and then change match types. And all the broad match related keywords to be converted into phrase match. I go ahead and do that. And all the keywords becomes into phrase. Now, if I have to add in, let's say, negative keyword, I will go further down. Okay, they have actually changed that. Earlier, it used to be on the down. I got to know that there is a separate tab now, right? There's a separate tab now created for negative. So negative keywords. Okay, Sandeep has a question. If I sell tennis shoes for men and women in India, which keyword will be best for limited budget? Okay, so then in that case, you will have separate keywords. You can have one keyword as tennis shoes for men. You can have tennis shoes for men and women. You can have tennis shoes for women. And if you have separate landing pages, Sandeep, let's say you have one landing page where all the tennis shoes related to men are there, then you will have a different ad copy and ad for that, right? Where the destination URL will only be for the men. One ad copy targeting the tennis shoes for men, the destination URL is also of that web page where all the tennis shoes of men are actually showcased across. Similarly, if you have tennis shoes for women, then you have a different ad copy and different landing page for that. That'll make a lot of sense. Just like in case I have red tennis shoes, I'll have only red tennis shoe landing page, a different ad copy for red tennis shoes and different destination URL for that. Does that answer your question? Let me know in case it doesn't. I can surely go ahead and explain it furthermore. All right, so negative keywords. Okay, you got that. Great. So negative keyword, I can click over here. Underneath keywords, we have the keywords part, which I've already shown you. Then the negative keywords. Now, this has actually changed. Earlier, we used to have at the bottom level. I can go ahead and click on plus keyword. And then let's say if I type in free, I don't provide free online training classes, right? So I can mention across one of the word as free. If somebody types in free online marketing courses, let's say if I've got this negative keywords, I go back to my keywords once more. Over here, if I have this phrase match online marketing courses, if somebody types in free online marketing courses or free web marketing courses, my ad could have triggered. But I don't want anybody who types in the word free along with these words before or after. I don't want my ad to be triggered. So I know that I'm not going to run my waste my clicks on those people who are looking for free classes, free sessions. I need money to actually, you know, sponsor across my kharcha also, right? So that's what that's all in the keyword match types, guys. Now let me show you how the display campaigns work. this is with the search campaigns, guys. All right, now the next thing comes in display campaign. All we have to do is, again, we have to go to the home page. Okay, not the home page, rather go into the campaigns part over here. In the campaigns part, click on all campaigns. So when it says for a particular service, how to search the keyword. Okay, example, bulk SMS. Okay, over here in the keyword match type, if you type in bulk SMS, so let's say if you're providing bulk SMS services, what your end audience generally type across when they are looking for bulk SMS services, you can get a lot of information from the Keyword Planner tool only. So let's say if I type in bulk SMS services in Keyword Planner tool, I press enter, it gives me a lot of information that what are people typing across. It says bulk SMS service in India is bulk SMS service in India is 70 average monthly search. SMS service provider, free bulk SMS, bulk SMS service in Delhi, so forth and so on. Is that what your question was? Does that answer your question? All right. Okay. You can also, so let's say, guys, right now, if you're not getting questions, and tomorrow later on, you'll get questions, you can always WhatsApp me. You can always WhatsApp me with whatever queries you'll have. So are we all good, guys? Should we move ahead with the display campaigns? Arushi, are you good? Nand Kumar, Payal, Rajiv, Rohit, Sagar, Sandeep, Sundar, Swandeep, Vinay, everybody. So Rohit says display. All right. Yeah. Great. Thanks, guys. All right. So let's get started with, Payal says yes. All right. So Payal, I'm not able to recollect. Are you joining in for the first time? Are you part of any of our what do you say, face-to-face sessions also? Sundar and Sagar and Swandeep, are you guys part of any any of our centers also? Just trying to recollect, or you are all right. Just okay, you are okay. Which one? Delhi, Gurgaon, Indrapuram, which one is it? Okay, Payal says first session. Okay, but want to note default bit. Okay, Sagar, Ghaziabad. Okay, Ramesh Nagar, Sundar. All right. So Nand Kumar, the default bid is the one which you set initially. So the one which I had set in initially was the 50 rupees one. I can anytime go ahead and change my bid. My bid will always have a close impact on the way my ad is going to be appearing. I'll come on to the bid strategy also, right? So which we'll cover in the next session. Today I'm going to show you how display campaign also works, right? So bid strategy is something I'll definitely take. So you can anytime go ahead and change your bid. You keep changing your bid, you keep lowering your bid, and you can then check whether the conversions are happening or not. Okay, that's how you set up the ad. I will make this ad actually run, and in another 7 days, some data will be there in front of you to go ahead and collect. So I will actually deliberately try to run my ad on broad upon for some of the keywords, and I'll run it across on phrase, and I'll run it across on exact match for all the three, and then show you. All right. So what I'm doing right now is I go onto the campaigns part. I click on plus campaign. This time it's not going to be a search campaign, right? This time it's going to be a display campaign. It says that Google's network of partner website. What are Google networks of partner website, guys? Any idea? What do we mean by this terminology, Google's networks of partner website? Let me give you a hint. When we were actually understanding, the AdSense part, then these websites were actually in discussion. We were actually discussing about these partner websites. Partner websites are those ones which go ahead and subscribe themselves to the AdSense. Does anybody remember and recall that? Websites registered with AdSense, absolutely right, Sandeep. Sagar remembers. BD, different search engines. It's a great try, Rajiv. But these are different websites which have got themselves subscribed to AdSense. So Rohit says, other sites who have given permission to Google to show ads, absolutely. So if I go ahead and select on display network, which says Google's network of partner website, let's say, I have DM, absolutely. IRCTC has IRCTC does have AdSense on it. I'll just go ahead and check. Okay, they do have. Okay, thanks, Rohit. So absolutely, they do have. I think so. I can see that. So which is over here? What has happened? IRCTC, when we had actually learned about the AdSense, guys, if anybody who doesn't remember about AdSense can surely go ahead and look into the recordings, guys, recordings of the previous session. So I'll go ahead and all those who have joined in a bit later, let me share with you the URL for the recordings, guys. So you can go ahead and refer to the recordings. I've shared with the URL. Over here, the AdSense is enabled across by IRCTC website. They are trying to earn money. And Urban Ladder is showing across this display campaign. And Amazon is also showing across display campaign on IRCTC website. And also Udemy. Udemy is also doing it only with the help of AdWords. It's with the help of AdWords. Urban Ladder is showing their advertisement. And it's with the help of AdSense that IRCTC is able to publish this ad across and sell their particular space across on their website to Google. So Sandeep says, sir, from where can I access the recording of classes? All right, so Sandeep, I have shared with you the URL just now. If you click onto that URL, the recordings will come across, Sandeep. So bit.ly/dmp-videos. So over here, if you'll click, you will have the playlist. All right, so that's all. Okay, great. So I go back to the display campaign. Now what is happening? I have created the display campaign. I selected on display campaigns and I name it as, let's say, display Gurgaon one. Okay, then I go ahead and select what sort of display campaign do I want to go ahead and build across. So I want to go ahead and select engage with your content as of now, or maybe visits to my website. There are various other, what you can see over here, there are various marketing objectives. If I select no marketing objective, let's do that no marketing objective right now. I'll show you all the features. So display campaign, all features as of now. I'm not selecting a specific marketing objective right now. Display all features. I'll show you everything. Then I go ahead and select the location. So I go ahead and select the location as Gurgaon again. Okay. And the language being the same, bid strategy focus on clicks, budget being, let's say, 200 rupees per day. And delivery method, I choose it as standard, right? I've already shown you that difference between standard and accelerated. Then comes in ad extensions for display campaigns. Ad extensions work very less. It only so display campaigns does have text ads also. So where is your ad going to be appearing when we'll have display campaigns, guys? Your ad will only appear on third-party websites. Your display ad will never ever appear on search engines, right? Your search ad, your text ad was appearing across on the search engine, which is a property of Google only. But or this time, the display campaign will only appear on third-party websites, and these third-party websites are those websites which have sold across the space on their website with the help of AdSense, right? Anybody who has any question can ask me, guys, right? So ad extensions, we don't generally go ahead and use the ad extensions with display campaign. Now, the other things which are over here are same. You can schedule. You can mention on what all dates your ad will start and end. You can also mention the overall ad rotation part, which is optimize your particular advertisement for conversions or for clicks. As of now, I'm taking clicks only. All right, let you know about the conversions part in a while, in another session. Then comes in device, guys. I can go ahead and select on what all kind of devices should my ad appear. I can select that my ad should be shown across to those people who are using only Android or BlackBerry or iPhone. But as of now, I want to go ahead and show it across to everybody. Let's say, for an example, if I am Apple and I want to sell across my Apple product to those people who are using Android and BlackBerry, right? So I will not select iOS. People who are already using Apple, why should I show my ad to them, right? Isn't that great? This is great targeting. if somebody is who is already my customer, I will not show my ad to them. If I'm Apple, I will not select iOS because that particular person is already on Apple system, not there on cross on all the other ones, right? The other ones. All right, so all the other ones would be selected by me. Operating system can be selected. I can select the device part also, whether I want my advertisement to be shown across to those people who are using an Apple phone or an Android phone. If I select on Android, it gives me overall information, which one, Casio, Celcom, Coolpad. I mean, you might have never even heard of it. And these guys are targeting so hard, right? So why not, sir? We don't want to maintain the customers. Sure. If you want to maintain the customers, then you can create, let's say, Arushi, there can be different campaigns. It's a good thought, Arushi. Let's say if I have one campaign for Apple, which says that change your phone from an Android to Apple, then I can have one of the campaign and selecting only Android people. I can have a different campaign, which says that, are you happy with the Apple iOS? And are you happy with Apple? Then I can have a different campaign only selecting the iOS. So instead of merging all of them, I can have different campaigns selecting the different operating system, right? So that the targeting, the message is very much targeted. All right, so Rohit says it's all campaign objective specific and based on offline search. Absolutely, company strategy. Absolutely right. So I hope you're not saying okay just for the sake of okay, Arushi. I hope you are getting it right. You got what I was trying to say. It's like if I'm trying to talk only to the Apple people, I'll have, okay, got that. Okay, great, good, thanks. So similarly for the Wi-Fi guys, let's say if I am Airtel, okay? I'm trying to sell across Airtel Wi-Fi connection, Airtel broadband connection to those people who are not using Airtel, but they're using other stuff. I will not add Airtel, but I will add Aircel, BSNL, Idea, and so other. All those people who are using internet with the help of Aircel connection, BSNL connection, Idea, MTNL, Reliance, so forth and so on, will only get to see the ad, and people who are using Airtel broadband will not get to see. Somebody who's already using Airtel, I don't want to pitch across to them, right? So maybe this is another great thing, but for my particular case, I am going to select every operating system, every device and every Wi-Fi. I have no difficulty in that. So, all right. So I go ahead and click on save and continue. These are some advanced options which can be taken later on again. All right. So first, the basics have to be clear. Now I go ahead and mention across the ad group name. Let's say I mention it across display Gurgaon ad group one, okay, and then my PPC bid, let's say if I do it 10 rupees right now, I can do that. And now how am I going to mention across to Google that where should my ad be shown? This is called targeting, guys. Okay, I can go ahead and let Google know that my ad should appear on such and such kind of website. If I want to show across my ad to those on those kind of websites where the content is related to some of the keywords which I want to mention across. So first targeting option is display keywords. I can go ahead and click on add keywords. Over here, the keywords are not going to be typed across into search bar, right? When I mention across keywords over here, let's say online marketing course, or maybe online marketing, any particular website which is falling under the Google Display Network, which has subscribed to Google AdSense, and that particular website is based upon online marketing, on that website my ad will appear. Okay, now what I'm trying to do right now is to tell Google on what sort of website should my ad appear. Google, in its data display network, all those websites which have subscribed to AdSense comes under the Google Display Network, and there would be like multiples of millions of websites which are there in the Google Display Network. I cannot tell Google that please go ahead and showcase my ad wherever you want to. That is not the right thing. Google might showcase my ad on an interior designing website, or it might showcase my ad on a real estate website. It might showcase my ad of DM Patshala on a website which is selling across diapers. It might showcase my ad across on a website which is a spiritual website. These are not my audience, right? I want to showcase my ad probably on those particular websites which are very specific to my target audience. My target audience would be the ones who are either on the job portal sites or on marketing related websites or on websites which are talking about, which are giving across information about internet marketing or maybe about management institutes, so forth and so on, right? So Rohit says, so this would effectively mean that all sites which show up on organic search for online marketing and have subscribed to AdSense would display not only the organic, even if they are not coming across on. So Rohit, there's just one small iteration to your statement, which you say, this would effectively mean that all the sites which have the content related to online marketing, whether they rank across organically or not, is something which is not the criteria. Any website which has the keyword online marketing in its content, whether it's ranking organically on the first page, second page, or on any page, right? Or on the 100 page or on the 500 page or nowhere, but they have subscribed to AdSense, my display ad will be shown across on that website. So that will take the entire group. There is no functionality, Rohit, where I can select only those websites which are ranking organically high. There is another way to do that. You can manually go ahead and check out those websites which are ranking high for the keyword online marketing. All right. And you can post across, take that URL and paste that across on one of the targeting option, which is called placements. I'll share with you that. So it says, but that would only show up on searching for online marketing if they have this keyword in their content. Absolutely. If they have this keyword in their content and they have subscribed to AdSense, then my ad will appear across on their website. No matter whether it's ranking high on organic results or not, that is not the criteria. But the other part, so all the parts which you said, Rohit, is correct, but the organic, they have to rank up on organically, is not there. All right. Sandeep says, so ranking of network sites does not matter. Absolutely right, Sandeep. The network sites which are there, which have subscribed to AdSense, their ranking isn't really a question which is there. All right. So coming back to the targeting part, guys, like I was telling you, I'm repeating again. Over here, I have selected the ad group name. I have mentioned the CPC bid. For every cost per click, I'm ready to spend 10 rupees. Now I'm letting Google know that my ad will appear on those websites which have content on their website, websites which have content on its web pages related to online marketing or related to, let's say, internet marketing. This is one way, okay? I can find out related keywords. If I type in, let's say, find related keywords, let's say if it does provide me. All right, so it says, local business, internet marketing, online marketing, small business, so forth and so on. There are plenty of keywords which I can go ahead and check, select online marketing training, local business, online marketing training, internet marketing for small business, plenty of keywords I can go ahead and select, okay? Now the display keywords means that thing, guys. All right, the next thing is interest and remarketing, okay? Underneath interest and remarketing, I can narrow down my search. I can be very specific in terms of letting Google know that which sort of websites should carry my advertisement, and only that website will carry my advertisement which have subscribed to AdSense. That's quite obvious. I'll talk about that, Sagar. Until and unless Google doesn't have the permission with the help of AdSense that they can go ahead and post across the ad of the advertiser on the publisher's website, Google cannot do that. All those who have missed the lecture of AdWords and AdSense difference, they would probably be finding difficulty in understanding what I'm talking right now, guys. So it's very important to actually know the difference between AdWords and AdSense. Okay, Sagar has a question. What do we mean by impression? Great. So guys, whatever questions you get, do ask me across. That's a very great question. And an impression is something like, let's say, Urban Ladder right now. If I have opened IRCTC, this is one impression. Whether I have clicked on Urban Ladder campaign or not, but it has actually come across in front of my eyes. This is one view which has happened, Sagar. So Urban Ladder overall thing has come across in front of my eyes. So that's one impression. If I do a refresh and Urban Ladder comes over again, this would be second impression. All right. So Rohit mentions it's whenever someone sees your ad, even if they do not click. Absolutely. So over here now, what has come is ICICI Prudential and Crimson. For both of these ads, one impression has counted. There can be a click. There cannot be a click. All right. Okay. If I click onto this would be one impression in one click. All right, guys. Okay. I would definitely suggest you guys to do look into my previous videos so that you get more ideas about more stuff being cleared across. All right. Now the other part into the targeting options which we have, the other areas which we have when we have to decide, we have to let Google know that where my ad will appear. Is this one interest and remarketing? I can mention in the after selecting interest and remarketing, I click on select category and then I can go ahead and click on affinity audience. I click on affinity audience and underneath affinity audience, guys, over here, I can select what sort of audience I have, which I want to target. Maybe I don't want to target those people who are into beauty, maybe who are into business professionals. They can be my audience. People who are looking after do-it-yourself videos. Somebody who's a cooking enthusiast might not be an audience of mine. So I want to be very much targeted. So somebody who's a mobile enthusiast, who's a technology freak, can be my audience. All right. And so forth and so on. So these are not my other set of people are not my audience. Right. So techno files, people who are into technology might be my audience. Travel people, travel buffs, no. Political junkies, shoppers, no. On outdoor enthusiasts, nightlife, not really, not really. Movie lovers, music lovers, not really. So this is one affinity audience. Similarly, we have another targeting option. I can further narrow it down, which is through this. I go on to another option, which is in-market audience. In-market audience has similar kind of stuff, guys, which is some more categories. So Google segregates everybody in these categorizations. So I can again go ahead and select those people who are part of the education industry or employment. They would be the ones who are my targeted, falling under the targeted groups. All right. Now, the other part is the remarketing, which I'll take it at a later stage, guys. All right. So remarketing list is something which I will do once we are done with the display campaigns. So display keywords, interest, and then we have a different targeting method, use a different targeting method, which it says the topics, placements, and demographics. Now topics are, we have all the websites within the network of Google, which I have subscribed themselves to AdSense, have been again categorized on the basis of certain topics. Again, very similar to that, I can go ahead and select the jobs and education one, or I can select the ones which are related to my industry. Maybe that's the only industry which, or maybe business and industrial, maybe, or computer and electronics. So with respect to the categorization, with respect to the topics, I can select all the websites which will fall under this topic will come across, will showcase, my ad will be showcased across on these audience. Or the very good part is placements. Now watch this. I am quite a fan of the placement smart. I'm not a fan of in-market audience. I'm not a fan of the other categories. I generally go ahead and type in across those websites for which I want to run my ads directly. Let's say if I want my Google ad, my display ad to be shown across on Naukri website, I can check whether Naukri is part of directnaukri.com is part of the Google network or not. If when I type in Naukri, it does tell me that job related websites are these. I can go ahead. All right. So you have Naukri.com over here. I can select. So my ad will actually come on Naukri.com. My ad will actually come on Naukri Hub. My ad will actually come on Naukrigulf.com if I select. That is the best technique. So the previous ones I had just shown you because I had to show you, but this is something which I have, which is my favorite. So I can show my ad on timesjob.com, so forth and so on, right? I can also see whether Flipkart, if I want my ad to be shown across on Flipkart,
So it tells me my ad can come on eBay, on Snapdeal. My ad can come on Snapdeal, on Craftsvilla. All these various renowned websites I have also got AdSense implemented on their website, right? So Shop Clues is also there. Craftsvilla, I've already shown you. Then Flipkart is not coming across, but Flipkart is also there. So sometimes, so maybe their inventory has sold across. Deal Needs, so forth and so on, right? Plenty of websites are there. So I'm quite a fan of placements, guys. I go ahead and don't use the display and the interest part. I am not a fan of display and interest. All right. So does price differ? Absolutely, Rajiv. Price would differ from different websites. The websites which are renowned one will actually charge much higher CPC because they know that they have a lot of people who are trying to buy for them. So we'll see that. How will you know that? So once you will set up your ad, then they will start showing your ad. If you are not getting a lot of impressions, that means you need to go ahead and change your cost per click. So let's say if I have decided 10 rupees right now, I run the ad, my ad will run, but it will say that your ad did not appear at all in the entire day today. With your 100 rupees or 200 rupees or 1000 rupees budget, your ad did not appear at all. Maybe then there is some problem with your CPC bid. Then you will go ahead and improve your CPC bid from 10 rupees to 12 rupees. You'll do a hit and trial method. You'll keep increasing your budget one after another, one step after another, and then you will get to see whether it's actually letting the ad work or not. So Sandeep says, is it homepage or it's random? It's random. It's random, Sandeep. So for homepage, definitely they will not have the AdSense. These all renowned websites, they don't sell it across on homepage, and it's always going to be random. All right, so Sandeep, on what page ad already I have answered that. So will they charge me even if my ad did not show? If your ad did not show, then they will not charge you. Even if your ad will show and it's not being clicked across, Rajiv, then also they will not charge you. Let's say if I'm running across on CPC, whether it's a search ad or a display ad, and you're running your ad on CPC model, cost per click, and your ad is shown across on 10,000 times. 10,000 times it has been shown across on various websites. Everybody see your ad, but they don't click onto that. You are not going to be charged even a single penny, Rajiv, if nobody clicks onto that. All right, so that's with placement, guys, which I'm quite a fan of. Now, excuse me, the other targeting option is the demographics, which you see over here. Demographics, underneath demographics, I can mention whether my ad should be shown across to those people who are male, female, excuse me, or unknown. When we say unknown, Google is not aware of certain people, whether they are male or female or not. So I can select what age group do I want to target, what gender do I want to target. Excuse me. Okay, I have a question from Sandeep. Because Sandeep says, is impression counted in display ads or is it optional in display ads? It's absolutely counted in both the ads, whether it's search ads or the display ads. But the pricing mechanism, whether you want to pay for the impressions or whether you want to pay only for the clicks, that is only in the display campaign. So the question to your answer, the answer to your question is that it is counted in display and search both, whether you are paying as per click or not. I mean, if you're paying per click on per click basis also, then also. If this is CPC, then also impressions will be given across to you. That, let's say you have got 5 clicks and every click was for 10 rupees, 50 rupees you have spent. That 10 clicks might have come from 10,000 impressions, might have come from 50,000 impressions, or might have come from 10 impressions also. But still the impressions will be counted and will be given across to you, will be shown across to you by Google AdWords. All right. So once we have set up this targeting, guys, we go ahead and click on save and continue. What we have done right now. Okay. So what is, so the demographics targeting has no effect. Okay, why is that so? Not really sure.
All right, so after I have saved it, yeah, I saved all the options. That's why I then went ahead and changed that, right, Rohit? Right, so okay, Sandeep, I believe I did answer your question, right? Okay, now step one, which we did, we created a new campaign, and that campaign was a display campaign. That was step one. And underneath the step one, while creating a display campaign, we selected all the settings. What were the settings? The settings were, which were, it was asking us, was related to the language, was related to the location where my ad will be shown. Well, it was related to the ad scheduling, when my ad will start, when will my ad stop, so forth and so on. After doing that, it was the targeting option. Where will my ad show? Now, after once we are done with letting Google know that my ad will be shown across on such and such website, maybe on Naukri.com or on Naukrigulf.com or on eBay.com or on Amazon.com, once we have told Google that my ad will run for this particular location and it will run across on these particular websites, and after that, how will my ad look like? We don't need to be a web designer in order to create these display ads. Let me show you how is this being done. So what happens, the third part is the creation of the ads, which you can see over here. I click on create ad ideas, sorry, view ad ideas. Over here, once I click on view ad ideas, I will first of all take my landing page, which is this. I take my landing page and then I go ahead and enter the landing page URL over here. Okay, when I enter the landing page URL over here, then I would go ahead and click on show me ideas. I repeat once again, after setting up the targeting options, I click on view ad ideas, right? When it comes down to creating the ad, I click on view ad ideas. After clicking view ad ideas, I mention across my destination URL, my landing page URL over here, and then I click on show me ideas. Now you see the magic. This particular tool, which is called Google Display Builder Tool, Display Ads Builder Tool, will actually scan my entire landing page and will give me advertisements on its own, guys. Okay, it's taking its time. Just a second. All right, so what you can see right now, oh my goodness, they have created something else. They were not able to pick up. Okay, this is crazy. They have not got right things picked up. Why have they got this thing? Strange. Something wrong with this tool, guys, right now. I'll do a refresh and see whether they are able to pick up or not. Not really. Okay, let me use another URL just to see how this is going to work like. So let's say if I take someone else's website, anybody who wants me to show you another website, guys, which is, let's say, if I take in, let's say if I take in Snapdeal website and that too the kids section, okay. I want this to be promoted across. I mentioned the URL over here in the section over here. I'm not really sure why it, my website was not being taken. I click on show me ideas. It's scanning across. All right, sure. Next time I'll take your website, Sandeep. All right, so you can see the advertisements have been created automatically. We didn't have to do a lot of efforts in terms of creating the advertisements. These are the advertisements, guys, which have been created. I can go ahead and edit them also. I can select them. I can select them. I can go ahead and edit. All right, so Rohit, just 5 more minutes, we are done. So 5 more minutes in case you are, so we are almost done. All right, so
I can go ahead and edit that. Once I click on edit, I can go ahead and change the headline on my own. I can change the description. I can change the image, which you see over here. So if I want my ad to have different image in place of this teddy bear, I want something else. In case of the logo, I want something else. I can go ahead and do that part. All right. So once I have done with this, I can go ahead and get my ad running across, guys. So that's with display campaign. So that completes most of our basic stuff with our search campaign and our display campaign. I would request each one of you to go ahead and share across your what do you say, customer ID, which is this one, the 10-digit customer ID, guys, and then share across this, and then I'll send you an invite from my MCC account. And once you get the invite, you will approve, and then I'll be able to see your advertisement across and then give you comments. Right. So next Sunday, guys, we'll meet the same time, and I have the feedback URL. Rajesh, can I have ads with custom image? Absolutely, absolutely. You can have this, and then you can edit it. You can also separate. You can submit across your custom ones also, Rajiv. So when you had the create ads option, if you go into create ads option, you can go ahead and submit that also across. So Rajiv has asked me a question in private chat. So guys, let me share across the feedback link. So Rohit, you can drop off once you are done with the feedback, please. Or in case you still want to go ahead and drop off, no problem. So guys, I have shared across the feedback URL. If you can just help me across with submitting across the feedback on how the session was today, that'll be awesome. I've shared the URL in the chat window. Once done, please let me know in the chat window. So while you are attending for the first time, I would definitely like to hear from you. And Sagar, from you too. Sundar, Swandeep, also, guys, I would absolutely like to hear from you also. All right, great, Sandeep, great. So great, thanks, Sandeep. So do share across your feedback, guys. I've submitted across the feedback URL in the chat window. I go ahead and share that once more. All right. Thank you so much, Vinay. Highly appreciate that. Thank you so much, Rajiv. Highly appreciate it. Thank you so much, Rohit. Absolutely, we'll catch up next Sunday. Sure, Payal. You just text me across on WhatsApp, so I'll share across my credentials in case somebody, or for all of you, in case you want to be in touch with me, just ping me across on WhatsApp. Whatever queries or doubts you will have, you can just let me know on WhatsApp. I'll help you with that. So that's my number. I'll help you with it. My pleasure, Payal. Really appreciate that. Thank you so much, Sagar. Highly appreciate that. My pleasure, Vinay. I've got your ID also, so thank you so much. I'll send you the request. Okay, great. Sagar, can you WhatsApp me, because this will get lost over here. So you can WhatsApp me. You have my WhatsApp number. You have my number on which you can contact me on WhatsApp, which is this. All right. All right. Thank you so much, Swandeep. Highly appreciate it. So is everybody done with the feedback? Arushin, Nand Kumar, Payal, Sagar, Sandeep, Sundar. Sandeep is done. Vinay is done. Sagar, thank you so much. Thanks a lot, Arushi. Thank you, Sagar. All right. Sandeep, if you can just WhatsApp me, because this will actually move away. So Sandeep, do message me across, WhatsApp me across your ID. All right, thank you, Sundar. I hope you did fill up across the feedback form, Sundar. You guys can contact me across on WhatsApp. I have shared across my number, and you can let me know your customer ID. I'll definitely have a look. All right, thank you so much, guys. Enjoy, have a good night, and we'll meet next Sunday for sure. All right, take care. Bye now. Enjoy. Take care. Good night.